morning.
Wake up at
7.
I woke up at 6 to prepare myself, and everything cost 1 hour. And then it's perfectly 7. I just need 1 hour warm up, and then I can.
7 o'clock.
All right. Thanks, Finia. Thanks, Paul. So Paul woke up at 7 o'clock. Lita, what time did you wake up this morning?
6, because 1 hour for preparing and another hour for warm up, and then 1 hour for tofu.
All right, that's awesome. And Chris and Lita, what time did you guys wake up this morning?
Normally, I always wake up 9 o'clock because I'm a sleepyhead. But always when I do kung fu, I need to wake up so early.
Oh, okay. Getting up early is good because you can do more when you get up in the morning for some reason. You get lots done in the first few hours of the day.
For sure.
Somehow I wake up nowadays only at 7, but my dad still sleeps, so I sleep more.
Oh, okay. So he might stay up a bit later. Yes, Paul, what were you going to say?
I don't think my dad is a night active, but he works in the night because a lot of his students are from Germany. It's the morning in Germany.
What's your tip today?
Okay, thank you, Paul. Great question. What are we going to learn today? Okay, we're going to learn today about the Olympics. We're going to learn about the Olympic Games.
Ooh, I like the Olympics.
Okay, now does anybody else, do we know what the Olympic Games are?
I know. Olympics is when, like, it's the last level for a sport.
Okay.
A very good sporter.
All right, that's a good way to put it, Finia. So it's a giant sporting tournament that happens every 4 years. So it only happens every 4 years, the Olympic Games. Either it's the summer.
To go to the Olympics, but it was COVID before I did it. It was like the Olympic swimming in, what was it again? It's swimming in the beach, right? With the big wells. I need to beat the others. And the good thing is I will have, everyone has a very long, that they don't need to breathe up. They have a very long loop here that they get breathe.
Okay. Well, look, we're going to learn a lot about the Olympic Games.
I had the stamina, I had the speed, but COVID was there and lost all.
Oh, yeah, I understand. So we'll talk more about that and what COVID has done to the Olympic Games at the moment. Chris, do you know about Olympic Games? Let's see. And Chris and Paul, do you know anything?
No.
Okay, good. So we can learn.
I know a lot of Olympics.
Now, at the moment, the Olympic Games, it just started 1 week ago. Does anybody know what country the Olympics is being hosted?
Tokyo.
Thanks, Kun. That's right. So the Olympics.
Tokyo?
Yeah, the Olympics is currently on in Tokyo.
I think Tokyo is the most.
Ah, very good, Paul. We'll talk about Taekwondo.
Now, I think Tokyo is the most place where the Olympic Games are.
Ah, great question, Finia. This is really good. We're going to learn a lot about, we're going to find a lot of facts about Olympics. Now,
Olympics.
Now, let's just quickly.
Will we find fun facts?
Yeah, we're going to find fun facts. And what I liked about your fun fact, Finia, is I've always been interested in which country has the Olympic Games more than anybody else, because who knows when the Olympic Games...
I think it's Tokyo.
Who knows when the modern Olympic Games started? Does anybody know the year?
Not really.
Me.
So we're going to watch a short video about Olympics in a second. Now, just going back to Paul. Paul said the word of Taekwondo. Paul, you said Taekwondo. Does anybody know a Thai girl who just won a gold medal, I think 2 days ago, in the Taekwondo sport?
Win China.
Oh, she beat a Chinese competitor. Was it Kun Kun?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
Tennis.
Oh, that's right. And her name was Tennis, wasn't it?
Yes.
Okay, so this is really good. So let's have a look.
I think it's in the movie. I don't really remember, but I know she's called Tennis.
Yeah. Okay, so she won the first gold medal for Thailand in the Tokyo Olympic Games. So let's have a quick.
Taekwondo is tennis.
Now, Taekwondo, that is, her name is Tennis. Oh, there she is. Here we go. I'm going to share my screen just so you guys
can.
Let's have a look here. I'm going to share my screen. Okay, so here is the girl who won the gold medal for Taekwondo. Her name is.
Yeah, she. I don't know why, at least I know that what that with the, I think was someone, she just did a spin and then she was qualified and she got the gold medal, I think.
Oh, okay, so who can explain Taekwondo? Kun Kun, can you just tell everybody a little bit about what is Taekwondo?
Kick.
Ah, very good, Paul. Yeah. So, yeah, it's
fighting.
Yeah, fighting. Taekwondo is a martial art similar to karate, similar to judo or Muay Thai. It's a type of martial
judo.
So there's Tennis. So she has made. She is the first Taekwondo Olympic gold. Her name is Pani Pak. And she wins for Thailand, and her nickname was Tennis. So that was a very proud moment for Thailand. So the Olympics have so many different sports. Let's go through.
Yes, there's Olympics for chess.
Let's go through and find out how many Olympic sports we can think of.
It's so many, can I even think?
Okay, so just so everybody understands, this is the story behind the Olympic Games. So Thailand hasn't won a lot of gold medals at the Olympic Games. And this is the 10th gold medal ever that Thailand has earned. So this is a really special situation for Tennis, the Taekwondo Olympian, because she's 23 years old. Already won two world championships and she's currently number one in the world. So she was probably expected to win this gold medal. So she's from Surat Thani. Does anybody know where Surat Thani is in Thailand?
Surat Thani.
Yeah, so that's where she's from. Where is Surat Thani?
It's somewhere in the south.
Okay, somewhere in the south of Thailand. I think you're right. Can anybody else help us? Is it south? Is it north? Is it central Thailand? Where is Surat Thani?
Surat Thani. I think it's in the south of Thailand.
Okay, you are correct, Phineas. So Surat Thani is in the south of Thailand. So. And down here, we can see that Tennis, she had picked up her first Olympic medal 5 years ago at the Brazil Olympic Games. So before Tokyo, Japan, The Olympic Games were in Brazil in 2016. It makes her only the third Thai person in history to win an Olympic medal after gold and silver in boxing. So there was a guy called Manas. He won a gold and silver in boxing in 2004 and 2008. And a weightlifter called Pimsiri won a silver medal in 2012 and 2016. So that's a little bit of history about the Olympic Games in Thailand. So that's very exciting that Thailand won a gold medal.
Yeah.
So did anybody watch tennis win the gold medal? Did anybody see any?
Yes.
I watched.
Somehow, you did watch it, Kun-Kun, okay. And
I didn't know why.
So Kun-Kun, she was in the final, and it was another girl from China, did you say?
Yes.
Okay. I think so.
And was it a close fight, or was it?
Yeah, very close.
She is a 10 of 9.
But she was disqualified.
Hold on, because just a second. We'll let Kun-Kun answer. We'll let Kun-Kun finish off. So, Kun-Kun, is that true? Did the other girl get disqualified? Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And why? Why did she get disqualified? What did she do?
I didn't remember.
Okay. That's interesting. So she must have broken. I don't really know
why she was disqualified, but she did do like a spin, and I think she wanted to do a back kick with a spin, but I think that was a wrong move, so she was disqualified.
Now let's see if we can find out a little bit of information. I'm going to search here, Panipat competitor disqualified. Qualified means that you did something wrong and you can no longer part of the contest, the tournament. Okay, so that's going to probably be a hard one to find. So we'll have to look at that one. If anybody can find out why the Taekwondo competitor was disqualified, let me know and let the class know. All right, so what we're going to do, guys, just let's get more familiar with the history of the Olympics, what it is, by watching a short video. And I just want to find out as well, like, we know about we have the Summer Olympic Games. Does anybody know the other type of Olympic Games?
Winter Olympic Games.
Very good, Kun-Kun. So, yeah, we have summer and we have winter.
Oh, in winter, we do, like, those skis.
Yeah, so that's right. In winter, who else can tell us what events would be in a winter Olympics? So we got skiing. What else would we have?
I'm not really sure.
Yeah, I don't watch a lot of Olympic games in Winter Olympics because in Australia it's not that cold and we don't really have a lot of people that go to the Winter Olympics, but
and in China it doesn't even snow.
Yeah, correct. So it's very hard to So here's some examples of some Winter Olympics. Snowboarding.
Oh, right. Those kinds.
This one here is, who knows what this could be?
I think it's
so cold.
Yeah, very cold. So this one is, it's kind of like.
Wait, I have an idea. Ice skating, gymnastic ice skating.
Yeah, very good. Ice skating. Yeah, there we go.
Taekwondo.
See that?
Taekwondo, yeah. So these are winter Olympic sports, just to give you comparison. We are comparing between, like we did last week, we compared things. So we can compare the Winter Games to the Summer Games. So we could say, we could say the Winter Games are less exciting than the Summer Games. So here we go, some symbols. We're going to have a quiz on the Summer Olympic Games to see what, if we can figure out what sports are what. Here is the Winter Olympics. Here are some of the sports and some of the...
Wait, alpine skiing. I forgot that.
Yeah, so let's go through them. So alpine skiing.
Cross-country. All right.
Cross-country
skiing.
Yeah, that's the one we did, cross-country. So very long-distance skiing. Moguls, which are like big, it's very bumpy kind of mountains that you ski down.
And you can also do flips.
Yeah, so my favorite one here would probably be ski jumping.
My favorite would be skating. It's like dancing, like Latin dance, but only,
I like mogul.
You like moguls, Paul?
Oh, yeah,
moguls
are really cool.
I think your one would be this one, probably figure skating.
Yes.
What else? Who else has got a favorite?
Finn?
I think I will also like, Applying skating. It's like a short thing. Oh, and I think he also likes ski jumping.
Oh yeah, ski jumping. Okay, so that's the Winter Games. So we know that there are differences between the Summer Games and the Winter Games.
Let's search about Summer Games. I think we have all Winter Games already.
So here are some Summer Game symbols.
Oh, and
now
yes,
these ones are a little bit.
And I will show you which one I prepared for. This one I prepared for.
An arrow.
Let's have a look, Paul. So
I always wanted to do this one and this one and this one.
So let's hold off on this one here. What's this one, guys? Who knows the name of
shooting,
this?
Shooting.
Taekwondo.
Arrow shooting.
This one.
Okay, so here we go. So the first one here would be archery. This one, as Paul was saying, is? This one is Taekwondo.
Ah, Taekwondo.
There is Taekwondo.
This is running with people.
I have bicycle.
Now let me, Finian, let me draw the circles,
because
we'll go through a few of these and we're going to have another quiz later on in more detail after our video.
Which one?
So who knows what this one is?
I think it's like gymnastics.
Yeah, correct. That is correct, Finian. That is gymnastics.
Yay.
Here's a really difficult one. What is this one?
I know what it is. It's like you have a sword, but the sword is not flat. It's more round, and then it has a spike in the top, and then they edge it. Hi-ya, ya,
boom. Okay, yeah. So let's...
I don't know what it's called.
It starts with this letter. Can everybody see my letter? That's an F.
It's almost like mine. Mine is also.
Okay, F-E. N. Excuse my drawing here. It's a little bit. So this sport that I circled is called. So that's
dancing, right? Dancing.
Yeah. So that is Fencing. I've never did any fencing. Very difficult. All right, guys. So that's just a quick preview about Olympic and some sports. Let's go and watch a quick video from Dr. Binox, just to get a little bit more.
Dr. Binox. Teacher, don't forget to erase, please.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. I will go back. Oh, sorry. Thank you, Finia. Let me go back and do that. If I clear, I need to clear everything. Clear all drawings. There we go. Let me just share the sound. We'll put our volume up. Okay, can everybody see the screen okay?
I got it right. But you know what's great about Adapted Mind? If I can't figure out the problem, like this one, I can click here to get an explanation from a...
Very good. So that was a good... Stop that one. Yes. Okay, let's get back. Stop sharing the screen for a minute. Stop sharing. All right, guys. So I hope that got everybody a little bit more aware of the Olympic Games. Hello, Pun. How are you? Thank you for joining us.
I always thought there was no reason because there were different colors in the Olympic ring.
Yeah. So look, what we're going to do, let's just summarize some of the things that we have found out about what we just, what Dr. Binox just shared with us. So let's pick up some facts that we picked up.
Olympic.
So let's have a look. Let's see what we remember. So.
Olympic.
All right. So let's put in some, I'll make this a little bit bigger so we can all see it. So how's 28? So
Olympic.
Olympic facts. Okay, so
my color.
What did we find out? When did the Olympics first begin? So they began in a long time ago. Who remembers the year that the Olympic Games first started in ancient Greece? Oh, very good. I heard 776
BC. Let me write this down, okay, teacher?
Okay, you can take some notes here. I can also send this file to everybody. Okay, so... began in 1776 BC. How many sports were there? Oh, we got actually the... So basically it began in 1776. That was what we call the ancient. That's the ancient Olympics.
199.
Ancient Olympics. And then the modern Olympics began in... Who knows when the modern Olympics began? The modern Olympics began in...
Great.
Ah, very good. So, very good. So, they actually both in...
Possible.
In the ancient times, it was in Olympia, Greece. And the modern Olympics, who knows where that began? Let me just get rid of that. So that began in the same country, but actually just a different city. It began in Athens, Greece.
เขาบอกว่าโอลิมปิกครั้งแรกเกิดเมื่อคริสต์ศักราช 776ก็คือ 776
And let's go through the color of the rings. Who remembers the color? The color, I'm gonna write this, colors of the Olympic rings. Okay, let's go through the colors. Who remembers?
Five.
Okay, so actually that's, thank you for that, Paul. So let's put in the color of the five Olympic rings.
What green. Color were they? Yellow.
Okay, hold on. I'm going to write it down. Green.
Green. Okay, green.
Yellow.
White.
Black.
Black.
Oh, black also.
What else? Green, yellow, white, black.
Blue.
And blue.
Red.
Oh, how many do we have? Six or five? Let's have a look. Let's have a look.
I don't know.
Hold on, that's okay. Let's have a look. I think it's. It could. I thought it was five.
Five.
Olympic rings. Oh, there we go.
White no half.
So no white. So white is the background.
It has white. They said that in the video. White is background. It's white.
Oh yeah. Okay. So that white, the white color is important because Why did they make the color rings these white colors? Did anybody remember?
In background.
So what we're going to do, we're going to change that, get rid of white. We're going to put red, but we're going to put here. White.
Blue. And white in background.
Background. Okay, so. And we're going to just change this because it's going to be, this is the summer Olympic facts because winter is very different, but pretty much the same. But when we get to the sports, how many different types of sports are there?
Right.
Let's have a look. How many sports? Amount of Olympic summer sports. Okay, let's have a look.
42 sports.
The summer Olympic sports have included a total of 42 sports over the years, with several of the sports played in the Olympics being added and taken away. So sometimes they put in a sport and then they might take it out, but mostly there's been 42 sports played in the Olympic Games. So that's another good fact for us. So 42 sports have been played at the Olympics. Now, an interesting one that I like that Finia mentioned is who has hosted the Olympic Games? Let's have a look. Hosted. Who knows what that word means? Hosted the Olympic Games. Olympic.
It's like the captain of the Olympic Games.
Yeah, or the organizer, the home country, because the Olympic Games can be very expensive to make. So at the moment, we're in Tokyo, Japan. Let's have a little look about who has hosted the Olympic Games in the past. Let's have a look. This would give us a good list. Okay, so
both cities of the Olympic Games. Here is a list of all the host cities of the Summer Olympic Games since the first modern Olympic in Athens, 1896. The current Olympic Games host city is Tokyo in 2021. The following Olympic Games will be in Paris in 2024 and Los Angeles in 2028.
Okay, thank you, Finia. Hold on, Finia. Thank you for reading that. So,
no problem.
Now, something is odd about Tokyo in 2021. Now, why that should be 2020? Why is it 2021? Does anybody know why it's changed from the normal 4-year cycle?
I don't really know.
Okay, I'm going to write it here. So Tokyo 2020 Olympics was postponed. Who knows the word postponed?
Normally it was 2016, and then they wanted to do it 2020, but when COVID came, they made it to 2021. So
exactly. So we can see number five, Tokyo 2020 Olympics was postponed due to COVID-19. They didn't want to do it last year because the COVID was affecting too many countries. Nobody wanted to travel. So they decided, let's put it on in 2021. And then
is even worse.
Well, it kind of is. It kind of isn't, because we have vaccines. We have, people are getting used to it. So it's actually, we know a little bit more about COVID-19 than we did back in 2020. So, and now at the moment in Tokyo, nobody's allowed to watch the Olympics. All the stadiums are empty. The only way people are watching the Olympics is from TV. So that's a little bit sad for the athletes, because being in the Olympics, you want everybody cheering you on and being in the stadium. So that's not happening on this Olympics. All right, so we can see the next Olympic Games will be in Paris, in France, in 2024. Before moving to the United States, Los Angeles in 2028. Excuse me. Now, the good news about the following Olympics in 2032 is actually going to be in my country of Australia. It's going to be in Brisbane. So they just announced that only a week ago. So that's very exciting. Australia will have the Olympics, because it doesn't happen.
Maybe I will have the chance to compete again.
Yeah, well, I'll have the chance if I'm there to go and view some of the Olympics. But now we can see London. London, who knows what country London is in?
Swimming.
England,
yeah. Swimming, I was old enough.
Now look at London. London is the only city to host the Summer Games 3 times. It hosted it in 1908. Then it had to wait 40 years until 1948. And then it had to wait almost 60 years to host it in 2012. So as we can
see, 2012 was when I was born.
Okay, so you're born on the year of the London Olympics. How cool is that? So we can see that getting the Olympic Games can be quite a special thing for a country, and it doesn't happen very often. But we can basically say that London has hosted the Olympic Games more than any other country. In Paris will host the Summer Olympics for the third time. And in 2028, Los Angeles will host the Games for the third time as well. So there's three countries that have hosted the Olympic Games the most. It will be Paris, France, Los Angeles, United States, and London in the United Kingdom. So that is a little list of who's hosted the Olympic Games. And we can just have a look here. Here we go. We have a list of all of the Olympics. So let's go through them.
Wow, that's a lot.
Okay, so we have the number one, the first Olympian.
Greece, Paris, France. City
Law. Pronounce that one Saint Louis or Saint Louis.
Saint Louis, USA. Athens, Greece. London, England, UK. Stockholm, Sweden.
Stockholm in Sweden, 1912.
Berlin, Germany. Ooh, not held.
Not held. Now, in 1916, there was the World War One, so they didn't have the Olympics on. It was to be in Germany, but then there was too many wars going on, so they didn't have the Olympics, which was the Olympics number 6. They never had it. So I'll go to the next few. 1920, Antwerp, Belgium. Paris,
Antrim, Belgium,
Amsterdam, and Holland. Los Angeles, Amsterdam. USA. Berlin, Germany in 1936. Tokyo, Japan. Oh, so the Olympic Games in 1940 should have been in Tokyo, Japan, but it was also cancelled. And that was cancelled.
And London, England was also cancelled.
Ah, okay. So we can see that period of time.
Oh, and then they tried it again in 1948.
So look, over here we can see 1940 and 1944, they were not held because of World War II. So there was another war going on just like there was in 1916. So they didn't host those two.
So it means they tried it again in 1948.
Yeah, correct. So if you were an athlete around 1940, 1944, and you were really good, you were the best in the world at something, you couldn't go and play at the Olympic Games, which is really, really unfortunate.
It's really annoying. We like practice so much and then it's cancelled.
Exactly. Yeah, nothing worse. So okay, but then fortunately, yeah, London got it back in 1948. Then it went to Finland, Helsinki.
And Finland. In London, England, UK again, it's 19 again, and then Helsinki, Finland. It was held in 1952. And Melbourne,
Australia. So 1956, that's the first time that my country, Australia, had the Olympics.
And then Rome, Italy.
Tokyo, Japan had it in 1964. Mexico City in Mexico.
Teacher, I think Rome, Italy had that Olympics in the Great Walls or something. What was it called? It's like a very big.
I think I know the one you're talking about.
It's the Olympic.
I think there is. What was that one?
I think this one. You're talking about the Colosseum.
Yes.
Yeah. So the ancient Romans, they
I think the Olympics used that too.
Yeah, well, this
wasn't here. I think they
didn't have the Olympics in here, but they did have some very famous other games. They had like the Roman games. They had like gladiator wars and people fighting lions and many other things in ancient Rome. But it was actually ancient Greeks. The ancient Greeks are the ones who started the Olympics. And the Romans and the Greeks, they began to have wars, and the Romans actually stopped the ancient Olympic Games. So
and made the modern ones?
Well, actually, yeah, the Romans, they stopped the Olympic Games, the ancient ones, and then it was about maybe, it was then like 500 or 600 years until the Olympics started again in the summer games in the modern times. All right, so let's get a few more facts in here. So London, UK, has hosted, how many times have they hosted the games?
The games three times.
Who was the other countries who did it?
Paris,
France,
and Finland, Los Angeles.
Los Angeles, USA.
USA, yeah. United States. Two times.
Are there any other?
That should be it, right? Yeah, there are a lot of, but I don't know if it would fit in that page.
Yeah, so there are a few interesting facts, okay? So...
Yeah, but no fun facts yet.
No fun facts. So let's see if we can add a few fun facts. What we're gonna do, let's have a look at a quiz game. Okay.
I totally forgot that. It's like gymnastics in water.
Yeah, very good. So this is why this one, we'll go through and we'll have a guessing game of a few of these Olympic sports.
That's archery, that's swimming plus gymnastics, I think, plus dancing, that's tennis, that's basketball. Oh, wait, not basketball.
1 second.
That's swimming. Football, I guess. No, that's handball. No.
Okay, so let's go down and let's write a few of these in. So let's go here.
Archery.
Let's write that in. Okay, so we got archery.
So I don't know.
Swimming.
Yeah, no, very good point. Swimming. So it is swimming, but there's a special name that we're going to call
Bash.
This one.
Bash.
We're going to call this one. It's actually, we can call it artistic swimming. Also,
badminton.
I think that's. Oh, come on!
Hold on, I got to move that. That wasn't a very good placement. So let's just move that across. So artistic swimming for that one.
Yes. Badminton. I always wanted to do artistic swimming, but my breathing was not big enough.
Oh right, yeah. It's
badminton.
You need to be breathing. You need to be breathing really well on that one.
So I need to do more swimming. I got the flexibility, I got the strength, and I got the technique to swim. But I did, but don't know.
So let's go through. So Paul mentioned this one is badminton.
Yes.
Let's get badminton in there.
Basketball.
Very good.
Basketball, but. Oh, and that one is volleyball.
Wait, what is it?
Basketball.
Basketball. And
that's
volleyball.
That is
a bicycle. Ah, bicycle. Oh, we call that one. Who's got the official name for that one?
I don't think it's called bicycle, but I think it's more like.
This one here would be beach volleyball.
And I always thought it's called volleyball.
Okay.
Bicycle.
Yeah, so bicycle. So officially we're going to call that cycling, Paul. So.
Oh, yeah, right. It's called cycling.
Now I'm going to run out of a bit of space. I'm going to just put up some labels here. So cycling. I love cycling. Cycling's one of my favorites.
That's Muay Thai, I think.
Somebody's calling you.
Backspin.
Oh, someone's calling me. I can see someone's got their hand raised.
Walk feeler.
Chuck E. Cheese, what would you like to say?
I will call the bicycle.
That's Gal. How are you, Gal?
Yep, I'll call it BMX.
Ah, do we have BMX here?
Oh, right, BMX there. There, cycling is not... Right, crowd.
Oh,
right.
Yeah, look, that's
BMX.
A gal.
Stop
very good.
Swim.
Now,
with
you know
BMX,
what?
We do like flips and something.
Actually, guys, that's a good one. Actually, you know what? I think that is cycling, but there is BMX in the Olympics as well. So we'll go and have a look at the difference between cycling at the Olympics and BMX.
Yeah. Cycling is more in one and
one.
I think cycling is only in
100
without raising their front or back cycle, but I think BMX is more raising their cycles and making flips. I think that's flip swim.
Yeah, look, it's actually a funny one. So Gal, good answer there. Like I think with cycling, that what tells me it's cycling is the person is like leaning down, resting their arms.
Their head is falling down.
No, next.
Now, what about this next one? What's the next one here? The guy.
It looks like flip swim.
Okay, so what we're gonna do? We're gonna call a
gymnastic.
Diving.
Oh, diving in right, the water. Right. There is like a
the water.
Then you just jump
in the water.
Make a beautiful
Jumping
swim.
In the water. So that's diving. Oh no, I'm gonna lose all my labels.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna.
Mr. Teacher Mark.
I will send it to everyone. I will make a screenshot.
Jumping Mark.
Hold on. Sorry, go ahead.
Can you mute some people first? Because it's really hard to explain. Can you see the button?
I'm going to do because my annoting is going to disappear. So I'm going to just delete this and then.
Looks like
I made a screenshot. I can send it to teacher Nan Oaks, and then Nan Oaks send it to the others.
Yeah, that would be great, Finia. Do you take a screenshot of that one so we can have a record of that?
I already made a screenshot.
Fantastic. All right, so I'm gonna clear.
Ducking.
Let's clear the top section and let's go to the next section.
Okay. Ducking.
All right, so we got a few more here. Let's go. Two, the one on the horse.
I didn't know there was mining.
Who can tell me about the one on the horse?
Oh, riding a horse. And that's gymnastics, and that's sailing a boat, and that's skates, and that. What?
Okay, let's go to the one on the horse. Oops.
I only want gymnastics. On the two,
skateboard.
Who knows this one, guys? Anyone know the horse riding event?
That's golf? No, that's not golf.
Actually, no, that was golf. It looks like an axe, but it is golf.
X, Y, Z.
Is it golf? Golf? Yes.
Guys, this is this here is equestrian.
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 Equestrian
is where the horses are like dancing.
I always want to ride a horse, but somehow it's so expensive, the courses.
Yeah, you're right. It's an expensive sport. You're right, Finia. Horse riding is not cheap. Who remembers what this one is with the guy holding the sword?
Fencing.
We did that one before, so fencing.
And I think that's... What is that?
Yeah, who knows this one?
Hockey!
Very
hockey,
good.
Hockey!
Oh, let me spell that right. Hockey. There we go.
Hockey.
Golf.
Yeah. So I think Chen answered this before. So we know that's golf. It does. I think it looks like an axe.
Yeah, like the axe to mine.
And you
I think they're making that like it's like
a gymnastic.
That's like the
wind. That's gymnastics.
Gymnastics. Like, very good.
I can show you my handstand.
Hold on. So who can help me spell gymnastics?
I'll show you my handstand.
Sailing. Oh, sailing. Who said sailing? That was good. Was that you,
Chris? Sailing.
So, okay, sailing, yeah. Who likes to go sailing?
Skateboard.
Sailing is when I get bored and then I sail with my
board. And
that's skating.
Surf. And the surf. And the surf.
Skateboarding.
Oh, and that's surfing. That's surfing.
A surfing.
We're going to put surfing. It is surfing. I was watching surfing at the Tokyo Olympics just the other day.
And you know, I even did surfing. It was like a competition, right? And I was the first and fastest and and I didn't fall.
Wow. Yeah, you know what? I didn't. Surfing is a very new sport at the Olympics. And I didn't think there was any surfing waves in Japan, but the other night I was watching some surfing and the beach was really nice and the waves were quite big.
Yes, it was, but in Thailand, normally in Thailand the waves are bigger. but I think that time in Japan, it's mostly big in summer. So, correct, but yeah. I did with a little small waves, and it was so fun. I even got to jump.
Correct. Now, okay, so we got this. We got equestrian, fencing, hockey, golf, gymnastics, sailing, skateboarding, and surfing.
I made a screenshot.
Make a screenshot. Surfing. Also, I've also saved this one.
Surfing.
All right, so.
Yeah, this is my hand, but I don't have enough space.
Okay, all right, good one, guys. So I'm going to have a quick look at one of my favorite sports that I like to watch. And I'll get a suggestion off one of you, or one boy and one girl from the class, and we'll just have a quick look at what that sport looks like. So,
hello.
My favorite sport. This is my favorite one. Has anybody watched this? It's the 10 meter diving.
Arashi.
Swimming. Oh, I love diving too. It's like we even get to make it like a flip, three times the flip, and then dive very deep in. That's why the water is not so narrow in the
arrow.
We're just going to watch a quick, some quick video of a few.
I like archery.
Oh, you like archery?
Archery.
Paul likes archery. So, guys, let's have a look.
I always wish to try to shoot one bow. Only one shot. I just wish to shoot one shot.
Okay, guys, we're going to have a quick look at this this event from Rio 2016. Does anybody know where Rio is? Which country?
Not really.
Does anybody know where Rio is? The Olympic Games were there in 2016.
I'm not really sure.
Okay, so Rio de Janeiro is in Brazil. Okay, now this is a 10-meter platform. The 10-meter is a very high, it's the highest place for them to dive. And this is a gold medal, this is a gold medal win to a boy named Chen. Now, before we start this, let's just go back. In the Olympic Games, what type of medals are there? What are the three medals that you win? What's the medal you win when you come first?
Golden medal, and then silver medal, and then like pinkish red.
Yes, that's the most expensive one.
Yes, and you almost don't have enough money to buy it, so you need to win it.
Exactly, yes. Because Olympic athletes don't earn a lot of money. They mainly get the medal, and maybe when they go back to their home country, they can be celebrities. They can go on TV.
If I wouldn't look behind me, I would win.
Wow. Okay, guys. Now look, we're going to do one more very special Olympic moment, and it's an American swimmer called Michael Phelps.
I know that.
You know Michael Phelps?
Yes.
So he's one of the most famous swimmers ever. He always won so many gold medals. He's now finished. He's now too old, so he doesn't race anymore. But we're going to look at this one, which is the 200 meter individual medley at the Rio.
You know, I'm already very tired in 100 meters.
Okay, so guys, this is a 200 meter race. Does anybody know how many laps of the pool it's going to take for 200 meters?
4 times. So it means 200 meters. Oh, 200 meters is like, four styles.
Correct. So the swimming pool is 50 meters. So this is going to be 4 laps. Now, a medley means that for each 50 meters, he's going to do a different stroke. Does anybody
know what are the different
swimming strokes?
I know. I can do all of them. It's like, it's butterfly.
Butterfly.
It's frog.
Well, that's breaststroke. Frog is breaststroke.
Yes, breaststroke and
freestyle.
Freestyle.
I can't find the winner. Yeah, I can't find the winner.
Michael Phelps is winner.
Ah, very good. Michael Phelps will be the winner most likely. So let's go through the list.
Wait, and Dan. The fifth one is normally only for juniors.
So we got, hold on for a sec, Phineas. So we got Japan, Great Britain, Brazil, USA, USA, Japan, China, and Germany. Okay, now Germany. Let's watch this one to finish off today, guys, because let's see how this race goes.
There's the lineup contesting the gold, silver, bronze.
Just get a little bit fast, Frank.
Okay. Placings, top eight.
So we're in Brazil again. There's Michael Phelps. There's the American.
Very impressive. This man, 25.
Okay.
Olympic Games trials.
So here are the starting blocks. They're ready to go. Very nervous.
Pereira's name. His Christian name.
A very nervous time getting ready to race.
He's been to six world championships.
Got his goggles. Olympic Games. Well, that guy's got some Olympic rings on his tattoo on his arm.
That's good. They allowed the crowd
forward a little bit.
Five. This man is at four. He's lofty.
Okay, so did everyone hear the whistle?
Whistle, prepare.
Yeah, whistle, prepare. Get ready to start.
Now that's so Pereira
the first
go.
Stroke they're doing.
Got him pumped.
What are they doing?
He's up
first
and he's
here?
Alongside Phelps. So Pereira, third from the right,
so the
towards the top of the screen, alongside of him, and Lofty too, and Hugino, they're all on the line.
Pereira just edging slightly in front of this early stage into the butterfly. They're going to go into the backstroke now. Does he take the honors? The crowd will go crazy.
Brazilian line number 24-74.
Phelps is lurking though. 1.7 behind. Phelps is underwater. Are so good in this tour that I am. Don't ride off Ryan Lofty. He's a past champion of the 200 backstroke. He's going to try and go with Phelps here.
And Hugino as well. They've all got good breaststroke form, but the three
out there
now, Pereira, Phelps and Lofty. Phelps may be in front. Just
okay, see that yellow line? That's the world record.
This is sensational.
They stay in front
now,
of that, they'll be the
how
record.
Does Pereira go in the breaststroke? He was found a little bit wanting.
That's
butterfly.
But he's still there now.
Okay, here's the front.
Butterfly makes very tired.
His breaststroke has been working pretty well for him at this Olympic camp.
We've only got how many meters left? I think.
But he's got some company. He's not shaking it off as easy as some of the other events, but once he hits the freestyle, his freestyle has really been firing well here in Rio. And amazingly, he is right on the world record line.
Fujimori in lane one moved up to fourth. Phelps, Pereira, Lofty, Brazil looking for a medal. The crowd deafening here. The mighty Michael Phelps.
The champion is leading. He's had a very big campaign. Pereira is throwing everything at him, but Phelps is increasing the lead, increasing the stroke rate.
There has never been a better swimmer. The most decorated swimmer is miles ahead.
So Michael Phelps.
Michael Phelps.
Oh, the Japanese swimmer came
extraordinary yet again.
1.95 seconds was the margin in victory. Four times he wins the 200 meters individual medley. The
okay,
first.
Okay, guys. So we'll just turn that one off now. Okay, guys. So I hope everybody enjoyed the class today and got some more knowledge about the Olympics. Does anybody have any questions they would like to ask before we finish?
I wonder if in the Olympics there are trophies.
Yeah, are there trophies? Actually, no, Finia, there are no trophies. The only thing they give are medals.
Gold medals.
Yeah, the only medals. But let's say for the Thai girl who won the Taekwondo, her name was Tennis. When she comes back to Thailand, the Thailand government or the people of Thailand might give her a really big trophy. because they'll be so proud of her being that she won the Olympic medal for Thailand.
Normally, this is not so big, like the trophy who got the, this is the fifth. They were so surprised. I was just 8 years old. And then I got like the first. Normally 8 years old couldn't even compete, but I looked so much mature that I could go in there.
Oh, yeah, very good. All right, guys, we are just about finished. Before we do, who would like to play a Kahoot game?
Kahoot game?
Shall we play? We'll play a quick game before we finish, okay?
Okay.
So we'll test how much everybody knows about the Olympics. So let's have a look. Give me a minute. We'll just go and find a game. Okay, so we're gonna find a game and so we're gonna learn our quiz about Olympic facts. And for next week, let's see if we can find some fun facts about Olympics and we'll add those to our list.
I don't know if there is even fun facts in the Olympic Games.
I'm sure there would be some.
I think you cannot let this thing fall, because if it falls, it will break in pieces.
Okay, so let's. Okay, so we'll quickly. We've got a few minutes left, so I'll share the screen, and we'll go through a quick Kahoot quiz. Okay, so let's just let Gao is joining us. 15 questions, 24 questions. Okay, let's go to 15, 10, 12. Okay.
How about 15? That long? 14 question, 15? I think 15 question is okay.
Yeah, 15 should be okay. I'm just looking at one that a lot of people have played because it'll be the best. All right, so let's have a look at this one. 15, yeah, so that's a good one. That could be a little
bit. It's not in the Olympics.
Let's go to the history. We may not be able to do all of these, but let's try to do as many as we can. We've got a few minutes to go, so we'll do this now. What are we going to call our team? We're going to call our team.
How about
Wanyan Stars? We are the Wanyan Stars. Hold on, I'm going to get my other player. Come and join the quiz, help our quiz out. Okay, question number one. When were the first recorded Olympic Games held?
BC.
Maybe call out the color. Call out the color for me so I can put the... Okay, well done. 776. Next one.
Okay. Oh, we're number three.
Coming third. How many events were held at the first recorded Olympic Games?
Three.
One.
I think one.
Hold on. I'm hearing three. I'm hearing one. And this is the first ever one. You know what? Guys, I think I'm going to go with one because I think it only was like a racing. Okay. Oh, did I get it? Yay! Okay, so in the first ever, I think it was just a marathon, a very long race, because it just was the first ever one they did. So it was very simple. Okay, let's have a look how we're going. Okay, one have made their way to second. Okay, question three. What was the only event at the first recorded Olympic Games? Have a look at a 192-meter foot race, pentathlon, long jump, Dialis, 400-meter race, carrier race.
4-meter race.
getting some mixed answers. I'm going to go with the chariot. Oh, no. So that was hard. So it was a 192-meter foot race, almost a 200-meter race.
I told you, Jamar.
Well done.
Why is the correct answer all red and the not is the other colors?
The correct answer is always going to be in green and it has a tick on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the other one is all the other ones are trying to trick us into picking those. All right, let's go to the next question. Oh, no, Nancy's taken over. We're coming third. Okay, let's go to question four. Where did the Olympic Games originate? Where did they begin?
Greece.
Okay, Greece, not Rome, not Persia.
Greece.
Well done. Let's have a look. Oh, we're still coming third. Come on, we've got to catch up. Ready? Next question. At first, who were the only people allowed to compete at the Olympics?
Only
men from Greece could compete. So no other countries and not even the women were allowed, unfortunately, or the girls. Whoa.
Oh, we're getting at the top.
Okay, let's see if we can keep our number one place. Okay, by 648 BC, which other events had been added to the Olympics?
Resting.
Long jump,
and the marathon. We're gonna go for the boxing and the chariot racing.
Oh.
There we go. So boxing, chariot racing, which is basically somebody on the back of somebody on a horse in a carriage. Pentathlon is a mixture of running, wrestling, archery, I think.
Why did the men need to compete naked?
Oh, yes, I heard that as well. Well, back in the olden days, they didn't have a lot of clothing. So making clothes is quite new. So, yes, so they did compete naked. I'm sure they covered themselves a little bit. But they didn't have a lot of material to make clothes in ancient times. Okay, question seven. Why did the Olympic Games cease, which means stop, in AD 393? Okay, so I know this one. I'll help you out with this one. It was the Romans. The Italians.
Oh, right. The Roman Empire.
They banned all of these type of festivals and events.
Well, we got 863.
Let's have a look if we stayed on top. Let's see if we got first place. Stars are coming first. Let's go. Question eight. When were the modern Olympics first held? Not the ancient, the modern.
Modern.
Yeah, the modern. I think we...
I think eight. Oh, 1-8.
Thanks, Augustus. So look at this number, 1996. Yes. Okay, so that's when the first modern Olympic Games started.
Oh, or 300, 900.
So 1896. How many years ago was that? If we're in 2021, how many?
1,000. I can't even calculate.
It's hard, actually, isn't it? I think that's going to be, is it 200?
No. Oh,
it's only 100.
I'm sure 1,000.
125 years ago.
Yeah, that's a lot. Next.
Okay, 1 yen star is still coming first. Shimmer coming second, Nancy, Robin, and Mal. Okay, ready for question nine. Where were the 1896 Olympic Games held? Where were the first Olympic Games held? Which country?
I think unknown Great Britain or Athens, Greece.
Yeah, they were in Greece, the first Olympic Games.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, next. Okay, we got to keep going. We're nearly on top. Question 10. How many athletes competed in the 1896 Olympic Games? Many in the first ever Olympic Games. 180.
I think.
Yeah, only 280. How many compete now?
More than 1,085.
So in Tokyo at the moment, there would be almost 10,000 athletes from around the world. So a lot of people competing from all sorts of countries. Okay, how many events were held in 1896 Athens Olympics? Oh wow! Look, here is the medal tally. USA, they came first. Oh, Greece did really well, but they didn't win a lot of gold. Germany, Australia, they won 2 medals.
Quickly before the time.
How many events? There were 43. I didn't know that one, so I couldn't answer it. So there were 43 different events. So I imagine running, swimming.
There was 43. See, there is in that answer.
Oh,
there.
Sorry. Yeah, look at this. Yeah, well done. Look, our medal tally told us. There were 43 gold medals given out. Which means there were 43 events. Well done. I didn't recognize that. Okay, guys, one last question before we finish off, okay? And we'll continue on a little bit more next week about some Olympic knowledge and facts.
Fun facts. Don't forget the fun facts.
Fun facts, yes. What sports were introduced into the 1896 Olympics? What did they first
introduce? Soccer, archery, and diving.
I like that.
Sailing, gambling, and pencil thing. Shooting, fencing, and tennis. Yeah.
I'm gonna go with blue. Oh no. Okay, so
gymnastics, swimming, and waiting.
Okay. All right, guys. Look, that's the end of our class today. Thanks for everybody joining. Thank you, Gal, for coming along as well. Good to see you.
Can I probably talk to you after everybody leaves?
Yes.
Goodbye.
This one spins too.
Oh, cool. Okay, guys, look, everybody have a good day. And we will meet you again next Wednesday.
Yeah, meet you again next Wednesday.
Okay, all right, take care, guys. Yeah, sure, Gal, hold on there, and I'll talk to Gal. All right,
thank you, Fisher. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye, guys.
Bye.
And I will say, okay, bye. Bye, Pun.
Bye.
Take care. Hope you're well.
Bye.
Goodbye, Hamad. Goodbye.
Thank you, Kun Oak. If you can leave the meeting open, I wanted to talk to our new student today, Gal. So if I could just
Gal,
I'll just leave the meeting open. Gal is listed there as Chucky Cheese.
What do you want to say to him?
Oh, I just wanted to talk to him briefly about him joining, because I invited him this morning for our English class. And just wanted to just talk to him. I didn't send him another link to a meeting, so if it's okay, just for 5 minutes, I'll talk to Gal.
Okay. I will. Yes.
Okay. Uh-huh. Thanks so much.
Cap.
All right, Gal. How are you?
Good. Do we have what day is science class?
Science. Let's have a look. So, Oak. Gao is looking at joining the program here, or some of the courses. So